Welcome back. The OpenMW team is proud to announce the release of version 0.40 of our open source implementation of the Elder Scrolls 3 Morrowind. Please keep in mind that our engine is already in a fully playable state, with only a few minor features missing, and probably includes less bugs than the original engine. Accordingly, the time of new shiny features is over, and the release commentaries will become more or less a compilation of bug fixes and code optimizations. If you want to see new features, head over to the OpenMW-CS video of this release. Alright then, let's have a look at what's new. On the graphics side, we recently had some minor improvements. First of all, water reflections feel more realistic now, as specular highlights are turned off during cloudy weather. Secondly, Scroll improved our shader behavior in order to fix some issues with displaced and distorted parallax maps. This makes Lysol's normal map textures, which I showcased in the last release commentary, even more beautiful. Finally, the new version fixes oddly scaled particle effects. This can best be seen when looking at the tar pits, I guess, you find in Ashlander camps. The particle effect should now fit the pit's dimensions. In previous versions, resting interrupted active magical effects. On the one hand, temporary effects were simply cut off, wasting their remaining duration time. On the other hand, permanent effects, for example, constant enchantments or diseases like vampirism, were put on hold for the time of resting. This allowed vampires to rest in the sunlight without taking any damage, or made your handcrafted ring of constant healing pointless in camping situations. All these issues have been fixed in the current release. OpenMW formerly ignored hostile creatures or NPCs when checking for nearby enemies if the player hadn't discovered or fought them before. This issue allowed players to rest nearly everywhere without encountering the famous "there are enemies nearby" message. This bug has been fixed in version 0.40. The AI has seen several improvements since the last update. Creatures and NPCs now naturally wander around in places without path grid. This change affects the majority of Vardenfell's wilderness and puts an end to stuck-in-place wildlife. Moreover, all enemies should now be able to properly hit the player in fighting situations. This can be seen when messing around with cliff racers. Previously, they would only attack if the player was in the right position. With version 0.40, they've become as annoying as in the vanilla game. Creatures with ranged attacks also benefit from the improved AI behavior, as their accuracy has increased tremendously. Characters, which are supposed to travel along a set of waypoints, formally stop their routine after sighting through these waypoints once, forever staying at the final coordinates. OpenMW version 0.40 forces the AI to repeat the routine, as it was originally intended. Creatures and NPCs regularly check their environment for intruders. In order to do so, the engine performs a line of sight check. Older versions of OpenMW set a wrong level of eye value, causing the player to be untruly detected, for example when hiding behind the first stalactite in Elemezartus. This issue has been fixed. NPCs also had problems with choosing the right weapons for combat, heavily underrating the usefulness of ranged or thrown weapons at greater distances. I wouldn't say our current implementation is perfect, but it imitates vanilla Morrowind's mechanics. The rest is up to future mods. Have you ever wondered who put Fargoth's ring in that barrel behind the censors in Exai's office? Well, it seems that a certain Dunmer lady exploited a former glitch in our engine which allowed NPCs to get to otherwise inaccessible places when the player was waiting. She must have used this bug to get access to the courtyard and placed the ring there.
You seek information, Argonian?
Or, wait, With the current version, NPCs will respect the world's restrictions, even when the player is waiting. I guess we have to find another NPC to blame. Talking about accusation, I didn't do this. All these copies of a certain Bosma were dead upon the start of my game. But have you noticed the uniform pose all of these corpses are in? Previous versions of OpenMW did not randomize death poses for initially dead NPCs. And another thing, dead actors were formerly handled like observers, meaning that they contributed to your sneak skill. Creepy, huh? The current release fixes both issues. I mean, who uses sneaking in Morrowind anyway? With the new version, summoned creatures are handled like normal actors. That means magic effects cast by any of them disappear after the particular creature itself has vanished. And the summoned creatures themselves stay in game until the death animation has finished. By the way, this also marks the return of lootable summons, one of the many glitches the original game provided to imaginative players. Several bugs occurred when using constant invisibility effects. If the player activated such a constant effect and made it vanish by interacting with the environment, the spell icon was still present. Additionally, equipping or unequipping another item in your inventory made the invisibility effect reappear. The same happened when reloading a save game where you had already been discovered. All these issues have been fixed in the current release. Telekinesis is a useful spell if you want to steal an item which is well guarded. Previously, the telekinesis effect was also suitable for talking to NPCs and activating loading doors. Despite the fun one could have with that bug, the correct behavior has now been implemented.
May I help you, Outlander?
If your character is still a greenhorn or hasn't got any touch for spellcasting, magic scrolls may come in handy to allow them to use basic spells. In older versions, effects obtained from identical scrolls would stack, rather than override each other. OpenMW version 0.40 fixes that in order to prevent anyone from exploiting this incorrect behavior. Finally, the current release correctly implements the magic effect of slowfall. This effect allows players to slowly sink to the ground when jumping from high altitude. In the past, the forward momentum of a jump was kept, even if the spell was active, making your character crash into the nearest obstacle rather than guiding them safely to the ground. The issue has been fixed, restoring vanilla Morrowind's behavior. Another great example of Morrowind's really sophisticated physics simulation. That's all for now. If you want to know more about this release, check out the official release notes for more in-depth information and visit our forums on openmw.org. Next up will be the new FAQ video, and maybe I find the time to record some other project-related stuff. In any case, stay tuned for future updates. See you next time. Thanks for watching.